lived a spiritual guru, Umadit Pandey, a person who was very well renowned for his spiritual works, and he called himself to be a person who lives for the greater glory of God. His name spread around the locality, and he had followers of his own. His followers worshipped him and glorified his name. Umadit Pandey's preaching was based on the holy book, Bhagavad Gita. His preaching influenced many others to join his ashram. His preaching on Bhagavad Gita spread rapidly. Manu Singh, who was a Chhatri by caste, had strong beliefs in Bhagavad Gita. He was also influenced by Umadit Pandey's teaching. His thoughts and beliefs on Bhagavad Gita made him to show more interest towards Umadit Pandey's preaching. They spent a lot of time together. Manu Singh believed he would find solutions for his problems. Manu Singh explained his problems to Umadit Pandey. Umadit Pandey, taking advantage of the fiduciary relationship, had promised Manu Singh to execute his desire to secure salvation. Manu Singh was convinced by Umadit Pandey's words and agreed to give away his entire property to secure moksha. Later, Manu Singh approaches Umadit Pandey in his ashram and hands over his entire property's documents to him. After some days, Manu Singh realizes that neither his problems were solved nor he attains moksha. He decides and meets Umadit Pandey and asks him to return his property, but he refused. This angered Manu Singh. The case was taken to the court. The case was called
Manu Singh versus Umadit Pandey.
Manu Singh explains his act of being influenced because his mental capacity was temporarily affected. Umadit Pandey refuses the accusation over him and exclaims that Manu Singh had offered him at his own will. According to Section 19, a contract caused by undue influence is voidable. The judgment ruled in favor of Manu Singh, the plaintiff. The court held that it was undue influence and considered voidable. The defendant failed in proving the statement wrong, and hence Manu Singh gets back his property.